Good morning, students all. Last class we are discussing about the current electricity problems. Two problems are completed in the current electricity. We'll continue the remaining problems because definitely one problem will come in the current electricity chapter. So, okay. So, they given one circuit, Wheatstone bridge circuit they gave. This is unbalanced Wheatstone bridge. What is the current flowing through the galvanometer you calculate? That is the question. I am assuming here current I is coming from the battery. That current will divide it into two parts. Here I am assuming current is I1. Here current is I2. Here I am assuming current flowing through the galvanometer is Ig. See, here I1 is coming to here. Ig went through the galvanometer means current in this will be I1 minus Ig. Okay? And here I2 is coming. Here Ig is coming. So, this value I2 plus Ig. I2, Ig. So, in this resistance, current will be I2 plus Ig. I2 plus Ig, I1 minus Ig are coming to here. Ig, Ig will cancel. That is I1 plus I2. So, this is I1 plus I2. Okay, here 1 ohm resistance is there. For your better understanding, write here 1 ohm. Okay, and A, B, C, D are completed. Write here EF. We will apply Kirchhoff's laws to find the current flowing through the galvanometer. Then how to find the current? Let us see. We'll apply Kirchhoff's first law. So, applying, not first law, second law, KVL to loop ABDA. ABDA. In this loop, we will find, apply the Kirchhoff's second law. In the direction of the current, drop will be negative. So, A to B, I am going. In the same direction, current is also going. So, potential drop will be I1 into 1. That will be negative. Minus I1 into 1. So, again, I am coming from B to D. A to B, B to D. Current is also coming in the same direction. So, drop will be negative minus Ig into 5. Again, I am going from D to A, but current is in opposite direction. So, drop will be positive I2 into 4. That sum is equal to 0. Net potential differences in a closed circuit is equal to 0. That is KVL. So here rearrange the terms are I minus it becomes plus 5Ig minus 4I2 is equal to 0. Let it be equation 1. Next, applying again KVL to loop BCDB. BCDB. So, B to C I am going. In my moving direction only current is there. So, drop will be negative. So, minus I1 minus Ig into 2. Next, I am coming from C to D. Current is in opposite direction. So, I2 plus Ig into 3. Later, I am going from D to B. Current is in opposite direction. Plus Ig into 5 is equal to zero. With a little bit patience, keeping confidence on you, just you calculate, then this is minus 2i1 plus 2ig plus 3i2 plus 3ig plus 5ig is equal to 0. First you write i1 values only here, minus 2i1. Later you write ig values, 2ig, 3ig. So totally this value 10ig plus this value will get it as 3i2 is equal to 0. Let it be equation 2. Okay. So this is first equation. This will be second equation. We had to find ig value. Here three variables are there, i1, i2, ig. So we'll write one more equation, and by solving that equations we will get. So in this we will eliminate either one i1 or i2. You can eliminate anything. It's not a big task. So here this equation I am multiplying with, or first we will calculate. Later we will solve that equation. So what are that equations? I1 plus 5ig minus 4i2 is equal to 0. Second equation, minus 2i1 plus 10ig plus 3i2 is equal to 0. Next we are applying KVL again to the loop, this loop A, D, C, E, F, A. A, D, C, E, F, A. So A to D I am going. Current is also in the same direction. So drop will be negative. Okay, A to D completed. D to C I am going in the same direction, current is there. So minus I2 plus IG into 3. Next, here I am coming in this direction, current is also in the same direction. So minus I1 plus I2, that resistance value will be 1. Here battery is there. I am going from negative to positive, low to high. So EMF will be positive. F to A, nothing is there. So like this we can apply here. Minus 4i2, minus 3i2, minus 3ig, minus i1, minus i2, plus 3 is equal to 0. So first write I1, so minus I1. Next IG, only one IG is there. Minus 3IG, minus 4I2, minus 3I2, minus I2, minus 8I2 is equal to minus 3. These three we are taking to that side. So taking plus on both sides, I1 plus 3ig plus 8i2 is equal to 3. This will be second equation, third equation. Okay. So these are the three equations we got. By solving these three equations, we will get the answer. I1 plus 3ig plus 8i2 is equal to 3. This is third equation. This will be second equation. This will be first equation. Clear? Now simple. First, in these two equations, you eliminate i2. Using these two equations, again eliminate i2. then in I1 and Ig, one equation we will get. From that we will get the values of I1 and I2. So what to do? See, first equation, I am multiplying with 3. So 3I1 plus 15Ig minus 12I2 is equal to 0. Okay. Second equation, I am multiplying with 4, because if you multiply with 4, it will be 12. So 12 I2s will cancel. So this value will be 8I1 plus 80Ig. 40Ig plus 12I2 is equal to 0. These two will cancel and adding 11I1 plus 55Ig is equal to 0. Okay. From this, 11I1 is equal to 55Ig minus I1 is equal to minus 5Ig. Let it be equation 4. Okay. That is I1 value. Then this I using again 2 and 3. This is 2 and this is 3. You eliminate again I2. How to do that one? See, second equation, you can use this two. You can use this two, your choice. Second equation, you multiply with 8. So 16I1 plus 80Ig plus 24I2 is equal to 0. Third equation, because you multiply with this 3 here, so 3I1 plus 9Ig plus 24I2 is equal to 9. You subtract all of this. These two will cancel. This will be 13I1 minus 71Ig is equal to minus 9. Let it be equation 5. This I1 value you substitute here, you will get the answer. Okay. So what to do? Substituting 4 in 5, 13, I1 place minus 5Ig, minus 71Ig is equal to minus 9. So this value, how much we will get? Minus 65, 13 5s are minus 65Ig. Minus 71Ig is equal to minus 9. So minus 136Ig is equal to minus 9. Okay. Then Ig is equal to 9 by 136. If you calculate this value, 0.0852 amperes, that will be the answer. So we have to do like this for this type of problems. Next problem you see. Fourth problem, what they are asking is two resistors are connected in series. With 5-volt battery. Two resistors are connected in series with 5-volt battery of negligible internal resistance. Okay, a current of 2 ampere flows through each circuit. each resistor. Isn't it? Next, if they are connected in parallel, with the same battery, a current of 25/3 ampere flows through the combination. Okay, calculate the value of each resistance. Two resistances are there. We don't know their values. I am assuming their resistances are R1 and R2. Using that, we will calculate. So, write this problem, all of you. And what we have to find, R1, R2 values we have to find. So, let the two resistances are R1 and R2. In series, I is equal to V by RS, V by R1 plus R2. So here how much current is flowing, they mentioned current of 2 ampere is flowing. This is 2. This will be 5, this will be R1 plus R2. R1 plus R2 will be 5 by 2, this will be 2.5. In parallel, I is equal to V by RP, V by R1 R2 by R1 plus R2. V into R1 plus R2 by R1 R2. They gave this value as 25 by 3. V value will be 5. R1 plus R2 is 2.5 by R1 R2. Okay. So this is 12.5 cancels by 2 times. R1 R2 is equal to 3 by 2. This is 1.5. Let it be second equation. R1 plus R2 we got. R1 R2 we got From that we can calculate R1 minus R2. From R1 minus R2 whole square is equal to R1 plus R2 whole square minus 4 R1 R2. R1 plus R2 whole square will be 2.5 whole square. This value will be 1.5. 6.25 minus 6, this value will be 0.25. This is R1 minus R2 whole square. R1 minus R2 will be 0.5. Simple, na? R1 plus R2 we got, R1 minus R2 we got. From that easily we can calculate R1 and R2 values. 1 plus 3 if you do. R1 plus R2 plus R1 minus R2. 2.5 plus 0.5. 2R1 is equal to 3. R1 is equal to 1.5. Since R1 is 1.5, R2 value will be from R1 plus R2 is equal to 2.5. 1.5 plus R2 is equal to 2.5. R2 is equal to 1 ohm. R1 value 1.5 ohm. R2 value will be 1 ohm. This is the next problem. Okay, next. In the given circuit, calculate 1, the main current through the circuit. The main current through the circuit. In the same manner, current through nine ohm resistance and main current they are asking. So here what are the values are there means, here there is a battery and it is having some internal resistance. So directly I am representing like this. So what are the values here? This will be 3 volt. 0.241 ohms. This will be 9 ohm. This will be 6 ohm. This will be 3 ohm. What is the total current flowing through the circuit, first product? And what is the current flowing through the 9 ohm resistance? Let's see how to do. These two are in series. These two are in series. All the three are in parallel. That will be in series with this. So if we redraw the circuit once again, okay, by removing 3 and 3, R total, R effective, 3 will be in, or detailedly we will write. So 3 ohm and 3 ohm are in series. So R is equal to 3 plus 3, this will be 6 ohms. Let it be R3. 6 ohm and 6 ohm are in series. Let the effective is R2. 6 plus 6, 12 ohms. Okay. So by removing these two, here I can replace a single resistor of 12 ohms. I can replace here a single resistor of 6 ohms. I am assuming this is R1, this is R2, this is R3. So effective R1, R2 and R3 are in parallel. So 1 by R is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. 1 by 9, 1 by 12, 1 by 6. LCM will be 6, 9, 12. 3, if you take 3 2s, 3 3s, 3 4s, 2 1s, 2 2s, 6, 6, 36 will be LCM. This is 4, this is 3, this is 3. So, this will be 13 by 36, 1 by R value. Okay? So, from that you calculate R value. R is equal to 36 by 13. So, if we calculate this value, we will get this as 2.769 ohms. Then current I is equal to V by capital R plus small r. This value 3, 2.769, 0.24. Approximately this value will be 3. This value is 1 ampere. Okay. So, 6, not approximately, add this. It will be 3 only. So, current value will be 1 ampere. Then, what is the current flowing through the 9 ohms? Potential difference across R1. PD across 9 ohms, V is equal to E minus IR. IR. E value will be 3, I value 1, 0.241. If we calculate, this value will be 2.759. volt. So current through 9 ohms. Is equal to V value 2.751 by 9. We'll get this value 0.3065 ampere. That is the current flowing through the 9 ohms. Okay. We'll stop this discussion now. Enough. This is it.